have parity sphere from fair coins. Today can I talk about something I never see people talking about on YouTube. You talk about gold and silveration in different way. For people doesn't know the gold and silver, I make a full video talking about it. I can leave the link and the tag on the top by the end of this video. So I recommend you guys, if you don't know the difference, you don't know how stuff work, quote the link, click on it, watch the video, and come back, watch this video to make much easier to understand. Before we start, we are not financial advice. We use this information for my personal way to invest. I kind of created myself this way. I have no idea if there's books or anybody teach about it, but I know they don't like to talk about it. Okay, if you're an investor, please don't follow this video. Make sure you do homework, make sure you do own research. That's just information. I share my personal information to you guys, okay? We cannot talk about gold and the silver ratio the different way. What do I mean the different way? Today, as you can see, November 19, 2021, the gold is 1863, the silver is 2485 an ounce, okay? That's what you call paper trading precious metals. That's the price you can see worldwide. It's exactly the same price, and it's on the stock market, for example. Basically, that's the price you can see. Okay, it's not a physical precious metals, not a physical gold or physical silver, something you can touch it. Or if you can touch, or if you can hold it, there's a premium involved above those prices. Okay, before the whole pandemic, the premium was much lower. After the whatever happened almost 2 years ago, the premium skyrocketed. And not only the precious metals, but everything you think about, okay? Everybody knows what's the reason, okay? So today, the easiest way to see what that means, gold and silver ratio. So you're gonna take the gold and the silver. You can see the spot price. Spot price, that's the price available, easy to Google anywhere around the world. Just type gold spot price, or whatever it is, or Kinko to Kiko, or different websites. You can easily see that, okay? You can take the gold, the price of the ounce of the gold, and the price of the silver. You can take gold price divided by silver price. You can see a number. The number today, as we're talking, is 75. It's 74.96, okay? Let's do round number 75. Meaning that you need 75 ounces of silver for each ounce of gold. So basically, you're gonna need to make 1 ounce of gold, you have to buy 75 ounces of silver. That's called gold and silver ratio. Okay? In March 2020, was 125 ounces of silver to make 1 ounce of gold. So the way it works is, if you take it, right now 75, right? You buy silver, and if the silver is 80, so the silver is cheaper than gold, so you continue buy silver. If the ratio goes around 60, 50s, you switch over. That's the ratio, which means the gold become cheaper than silver, okay? Because you need way less silver to buy to make 1 ounce worth of gold, so it means you spend more in silver, so it's better for you to switch over to gold, okay? So for me, my personal thought, after 68 by silver, below 68 switch to gold. So you make money using the relation between the metals. Okay, so the way I kind of talk about is a different approach. Okay, the approach I kind of talk about is, you're not gonna see a lot of, unfortunately, a lot of people talk about precious metals. A lot of people write about precious metals in articles. They are direct involved with the business, okay? Or they have a hedge funds, or they work on refinery, or they own refinery, or they own mining, or they have their own bullion, their own company selling precious metals. So they have a lot of knowledge, don't get me wrong, okay? They've been in the business with many, many employees, with many, many laws to follow. They know a lot. But they want to talk, yes, two different ways. They want to talk the way they kind of share little technical information and transmit whatever is worth to people understand to continue buy whatever they're selling. That's topic number one. If they selling silver, they always gonna say the silver is better than gold. If they selling gold, they always gonna say the gold is better than silver because it's convenient for them. It's kind of like marketing their own product. And that's another a different approach, especially on YouTube. Those creators, YouTube creators, they kind of talk whatever the public, whatever you want to hear. Okay? If you like some topic, they kind of talk about the topic. If they understand behind the scenes the information or not, if they involve direct with precious metals or not, they choose a creator. Okay? It's nothing wrong about that. Okay? It's kind of like they put a lot of work, they put a lot of error in video to sell the information and to make money. It's nothing wrong about that, but there's a lot of good information out there, and there's some information you should check in different websites, you should check in different articles, you should watch different videos, and put together the information from different ones, different field, and to make their own decision, okay, without following nobody, because by the end of the day, the money is yours. But at the end of the day, if you're making money, good for you. But if you lose, it's up to you. And nobody is here to lose money, okay? Every single investment, doesn't matter if it's a precious metals, doesn't matter if it's a stock market, doesn't matter if it's a pounds, doesn't matter if it's real estate, and go on. Every single investment, there is a big chance to lose money. That's why I call investment. If everybody making money, investing anything, nobody need to work for nobody. Just keep investing. So the world is not gonna move because you need different people working different sectors to make the world keep moving. Okay, pharma, technology, industrial, construction, we need everybody. Okay, investment is not easy, but I always recommend whatever you feel comfortable with, invest. Because by the end of the day, is something can affect your life on the positive way if you know a little bit. Okay, and keep learning, and think about the future. Don't think 5 years from now. Think about 20 years from now. Because unfortunately, 5 years right now, the time is fried. Okay? So let's come back to the video. The way I want to talk about the way we do, and not say you must do it, is everybody talk about gold and silver ratio. Alright? So today the gold and silver ratio is 75. Maybe tomorrow is 76, maybe 20 years from now is 50 or 20, we don't know. But they only teach you how to do the price for now. But let's say you've been buying, stacking silver, you've been buying precious metals. I do the way it works is, cold. Average cost. Okay? I testified, I created my ration. I told myself, I don't know if people teaching there, if teaching, that's good. Unfortunately, I never read the article, okay? But that's the way too. I take a call and average cost. The most important here, even I can add this word, call divided by average cost history. It's not a history from the books, that's your history. That's your inventory, okay? So, that's the easy way you can compound investment. You can make money or if you already have on your hands. Those are merely half ounce of silver, if it's a monster box, if it's a time 90% chunk silver, you need to know your cost. Cost is most important. Every time you buy, write down your cost. Okay? Why you cannot do that? Because if you think, I think I pay X number, it's not working. Okay, you have to know the cents, the dollar amount and the cents, okay, all the way down to penny, because you're an investor, you're not here to guessing, you're here to guessing how much you spend or how much you think is worth it, you're not in the business, or you need to learn more about it, or you need to be more disciplined, okay? Will be hard for you if you go back to whatever you have right now to stock and casting numbers. If you cast numbers, you don't know if you're making or losing. But if you track down your penny by penny, you know exactly what's going on. Okay? Why I say that? In 2000, January 7, I kind of use the same date, January 7, 2019, right before the pandemic, the gold price was $1,245, and the silver price was $1,460. So you talk $1,245 divided by $1,460, the ratio there, back the time, I kind of define here, was 85 ounces. Okay? In January 7th, 2019, the gold price was $1,245, the silver was $1,460, really cheap, right? It's only 2 years ago, and the ratio was 85 ounces of silver per each ounce of gold. Today, as we're speaking, is 75. So the difference back at the time, the silver was cheaper than today. If the same, the gold was cheaper, but the average cost of the gold and the silver ratio was cheaper. Right, the gold jumped like $600, but back at the time was better by way it can carry more silver. Right, so when I say average cost history, because you know your cost is really important, I kind of go to next page and show. Let me take this off. I'm not a creator, okay? I'm not a YouTube creator. You're not gonna see a I'm doing editing videos. Unfortunately, don't have the time for that. And I don't even know how to do it. But if you pay attention, you might learn something. Or you might can use something on your advance. Okay? So, on 11, 19, 21. The cold was yesterday, 1863. If you use silver average cost, history, that's the name created, was 1460. The data used as a sample was January 7, 2019, right? So I kind of use the technique I use for myself. The gold today, 1863. The silver, let's say I had a silver pack from 2019, 2 years ago, I pay a 14.6 an ounce. So my average, my ration will be 1863. With the iron I have 2 years ago on silver, 1863 divided by 1460 will be 127 ration. That is the gold average cost ration. That's the name. Come back here fast in here to understand. That's the first page I remove. Today, 11/19/21. The gold price 1863. The silver is 2485. The ration, gold and silver ratio is 75. Meaning you need 75 ounces of silver to make 1 ounce of gold. Correct? If I had, for example, iron from, as I use as a sample, January 7, 2019. You can use any date you want. Okay? January 7, 2019. The ratio between gold and silver was 85. Okay? But if I take it, the gold today, it's 1863. And I go to my stocker, I have an iron from 2019, January 7, 2019, as I use for a sample. I pay a silver ounce at 1460. So my ration as today and average cost ration on my own history was 1460 for silver. So I kind of take 1863. The price of today divided by the price at that day of silver at that time. If you track down your cost, you know your average, it's gonna be 127. So it means you need 127 ounces of silver to make 163 ounces of gold. You're making a lot of money. In short period, in about 2 years. Why you make a lot of money if you use more silver? Because you want that piece of silver. So you kind of take it, I kind of go up in here. On January 1921, the ration life ration, it's 75, right? 75 on the top. And average cost ration, average cost ration used as a sample of 2 years ago, on January 7, you can look in the chart, it's a sacred number, I'm telling you right now, I'm not creating any number, okay, will be 127, all right? So your average ration is way cheaper, right? So if you take 127 minus 75, which is the test ration today? 127 minus 75, you have 52 ounces of silver as a profit. It's a 52 ounce of silver. It's a lot of money. Because you only need a 75 ounce of silver as today to buy 1 ounce of gold. So 52 ounce of silver you can use as compound investment. What do I mean compound investment? You take, okay, 75 divided by 52, which means you have 69% of profit. 69% of profit in 2 years as a ration, as average cost ration, you beat any market, you beat any stock market, you beat any real estate, you beat anything you think of. Okay, so how you can see the money? It's easy how you can see the money. You know, today you need a 75 ounce of silver to buy 1 ounce of gold, but your ration on 2 years, it's 127. So the difference you need for today is 75. You have 52 ounces theoretic for free. Theoretic, I say, because if you don't cash out, the money can go up or down because you don't control the market. Okay, so the easy way as investor, it's the way I do. If I see I make a money here on average cost ration, I will take sell it as silver, switch to gold on the date I had on January 7, 2019. Money-wise, total-wise, you still gonna have money left worth of 52 ounces of silver. But I still have the total sign, the total amount worth of gold. So I have a 52 ounces of silver in my hand in cash as a profit. That will be reflect at 69%. Okay, it's a lot of money. So I kind of take the total amount as a profit, and I kind of buy again silver. Because today, silver is still cheap. It's a 75 on ration. So I still kind of buy silver. So I cash out, I switch the money, the total amount I bought, I quote, I have left for me 69% of profit, which is a lot of money, and I reinvest in silver. If you reinvest in silver, we call right now compound investment, because you cash out, reinvest on top of the investment, the one stocker, and it's gonna continue move on years upon year. So you don't need to wait for, today I have 127, I have a 52 ounces of profit, and maybe next 10 years I can have a 100 ounces of profit, I can double. You almost double right now, you don't need to wait. So basically you sell it, take your cash, buy an ounce of gold because the ratio is okay, or he buys silver, whatever you want to do. And with the amount of the cash left, don't buy something else. Don't collect the profit. You have to reinvest. When you reinvest, it's compound. It's going to be on top of the top. It's going to become a snowball effect on your side. So once you take that money, you cash out, you see 69% of profit in precious metals, and to keep it doing. As long, the most important is know your cost. Okay, it's really important. and I prove that's how stuff work. It's easy. But let's say today you pour 10 dollars of silver, 2 years ago, 1 year ago, you pour 10 dollars of silver today, you pour tomorrow another 5, another 6. Oh, I pimp my silver almost every day because I don't have a lot of cash to invest in precious metals. It's okay. I took one plate as a sample, okay? 11/19/21 and January 7, 2019, because I have to prove how stuff work. But as long as you know your average cost, you can cross your average cost. You buy today, you buy tomorrow, you buy next week, $5 here, $2 there. By the end of the month, you put all together the items you bought. As long as you write down every single day, by the end of the month, you put it together and write down. Write down, today, November 2021, you spent X amount of in silver. And keep it going, okay? So you have to consider every single penny. Every single penny is going to reflect the amount here on your average cost history. And to keep doing, if you can in next two months you can flip it and keep it doing. Next 3 months you can flip it and cash out 5%, 2%. It's a lot of money. Those big companies in the world, if they make a 5% profit a year, they consider good. The economy, the if United States make 6% growth a year, it's a huge number. Why do you want to cash out 69 2 years? It's a lot of money. It's almost 35% a year. Nobody else does that. Então, track down your average cost, down to the penny, and keep it doing. If you keep it doing several times in 10 years, you might kind of triple X your initial investment. You don't need to wait for 10 years with the same investment, and then you might kind of do 1x because you're not doing compound. You choose follow the market. Keep it doing and see what's going to happen, okay? Once again, I kind of leave the link on the top, talk about the gold and silver ratio to make sure you understand. I'm not financial advice. I do myself for my own investment. Personal investment. I recommend you guys, if you want to get involved with precious metals, watch a lot of videos, reading a lot of books, try to learn how to work and make the best decision for yourself. Don't follow this video. This video is my own experience. I use for myself. Work for me might not work for you. Okay? Thanks so much for your time. I'll see you next time.